They weren't really making big gains coming into Spain. No really big upgrades apart from those towards the back end of the field, like Renault and Racing Point are making small gains but big in the battles that are around them. Here we go then, it's the Spanish Grand Prix. It's one of the best on the calendar and it's of course where we go testing. Hopefully it can provide us an exciting race. Hopefully it can. We'll see what the Barcelona-Catalunya track has in store for us today. It is 2.8 miles long, 16 corners, some of the most trickiest on the calendar, especially at turn 9, which of course is blind. Also tricky corners at 3 and of course the last chicane. So here is the grid then. It is Ferrari conquering Spain, just like they did in pre-season testing. Leclerc ahead of Max Verstappen. Then comes Lewis Hamilton alongside Sebastian Vettel on the second row. The third row is Carlos Sainz and Valtteri Bottas. Row 7 is all McLaren. Nico Hülkenberg getting the better of Lando Norris. On the final row of the top 10 then is Giovinazzi and Lucas Weber. Just outside the top 10 is George Russell and Alex Albon, the two F2 boys from a couple of seasons ago. Then it's Lance Stroll and Daniel Ricciardo. And then comes Pierre Gasly, who has a 4 cross qualifying. Sergio Perez 16th. Then comes Brown 17th and Kevin Magnussen 18th. And on the final row of the grid, both taking 10 place grid penalties, is Devin Butler and Romain Grosjean. Hi guys, Brown here, and welcome back to another part of the F1 career mode here today for the Spanish Grand Prix. I'm hoping this can be a good race, but we're starting down in 17th. We're going to be doing a one stop. This is a race I kind of had hope for, especially with the fact if you're around on the channel last year, we actually won this race. But let's stop the talking and let's start the racing then, as the 5 red lights come on here for the Spanish Grand Prix. It's lights out and away we go. The two Ferraris getting away well. Hamilton getting a good start. Vettel has had a poor start there in the background. We're gaining places. We've already got a couple. Now we're going to go to the outside. There's several cars. About 5 cars there all the way around the outside. We get Ricciardo there in the Renault. And now, as they head through this awful camera angle, and now around the outside we go of Daniel Ricciardo. He's trying to get back to some Ricciardo spun there in the opening lap, and now down the inside of Lando Norris. We tried to go here, we started P17 and we're all the way up into P8 and now P7, down the inside of Lando Norris there and into P7 of this Grand Prix. 10 cars in one lap, which I believe this is a replay of what happened. This was me kind of making contact there with Daniel Ricciardo, and to be honest I don't really know what happened. He just blocked off Grosjean as well. This is all on board down the inside. In fact it was George Russell, not me in fact, and then Ricciardo just reverses straight back onto the track. This is what happened from Romain Grosjean's point of view. So Grosjean just Ricciardo reversing like an absolute barrier there, the Renault wall as it were. This is what happened on board with us, and we just went down the inside there like that was nothing. Now on to lap 3, Lando Norris is coming back at us. We have to defend all the way around the outside. That then goes to the inside and we just about stay ahead in the background. Giovinazzi is battling away with Lucas Weber in the Toro Rosso. He loses out to that battle and now he's left defending our teammate as back down the inside goes Lando Norris. Is like the Battle of Britain side by side, and now around the outside tries Lando Norris again. We defend to the inside. That's what pretty much happened for most of this race. Round the outside, George Russell defends Giovinazzi in the Mercedes. Still odd that that's happening, to be honest. Giovinazzi in the Mercedes. And now skipping on to lap 4, one lap later, down the inside, he tries again, Lando Norris. that time though, it doesn't work out for him yet again, and we're left kind of trying to put our foot down. We didn't have any pace on these mediums, and to be honest, that's kind of the story of this race. Down the inside, he tries again, Lando Norris. We defend to the outside again, back to the inside it goes, but then it goes back to the inside for Lando Norris. Now we have to just charge all the way around the outside, the long way around, side by side, and now around the outside again into turn four, and we're still there on the outside. Lando Norris still there on the inside. We then go back to the inside for turn five, and we just about defend that, and now we push Lando Norris wide, and Lando Norris is left defending Lucas Weber. It's down his inside into turn six, I think that is, and now he does get the move done into turn nine. Somehow Lando Norris defends, because he basically lost that position, and now he's gonna try and focus back on us, I think. And we've actually gone wide there, you would have seen, on lap 5, and this absolute action already, and we're only 5 laps in, and up here comes onto lap 6 we go, Lando Norris defending Lucas Weber, and Lucas Weber has got the job done there, as we have kind of broken away from this pack. We've got a bit of breathing space in this race, but not for much longer. One lap later, around the outside tries Lucas Weber. We defend him, and now Lando Norris is gonna be looking back at Lucas Weber, but Lucas Weber's not finished with us yet. He's gonna think about it down the inside. He backs out of it though, because he knows it's way too late to go for that. We'd already turned into the corner pretty much, and now we just kind of have to wait for literally a one lap later, as down the inside goes Lucas Weber. We defend to the outside. That camera angle is absolutely amazing, just watching cars go around the outside. We defend that, but Lucas Weber, don't think he's done with us yet. He thought about it down the inside, but we make a big mistake here on lap 8, and Lucas Weber's got through. We defend to the inside, and now we go wide and off the track there completely, and we make contact with Lucas Weber into the corner. Lucas Weber's round, and they're all backing up this contact. That's absolutely monumental crash. The safety cars come out, and into the pits we go. This is the replay then of what happened, if you can make any sense of it. We go wide, hit Lucas Weber down the inside, and then there's contact. He squeezed Lucas Weber, but then he goes round and everyone backing into each other like everyone's dipping on the brakes on the motorway or something. And George Russell did a good job to not hit the back of Lucas Weber there, but everyone else didn't. Everyone else just hitting each other, and they're going to get three front wings like there's no tomorrow. There's Alex Albon hitting Kevin Magnussen. Kevin Magnussen losing his tyre, I think, and it was around this point where actually Max Verstappen retired. And this is a replay of what we did, because this was on lap 8, and literally we were at the final corner to turn into the pits. So this was literally a reaction, to be honest, to what to do, and I thought, let's just pit, go into the hards and see if they can go to the end. This is 2 laps later on lap 10, everyone else pitting, and I'm not too sure why they pitted so late. The safety car had already been going round for 2 laps. I mean, it hadn't caught many people because they were all backing up and going into the pits. But skipping on 1 lap later, this is everyone behind one another. We are currently sitting in around 16th in this race, which, to be honest, I'm not really too sure. Even at the time, I weren't sure whether it would have been best to stay out, but the thing that I realised was we pitted for the hards. Everyone had pitted for another set of the soft tyres. So on at the end of lap 11, when the safety car comes in, it will be Charles Leclerc who leads them round from the 2 McLarens. So you can just see the time with a loss by pitting, but then they stayed out. So these 3 stayed out. So most cars just got a free pit stop, but it was kind of see what these hards can do. But everyone else has just pitted for, if not the softs, the mediums. No one's really touched a hard like we've done, so it's Ferrari, McLaren, McLaren. And Charles Leclerc's bolted and he's gone then. And we are back racing in this Spanish Grand Prix. And look at the gap is already pulled to this behind, so that McLarens were slow off the restart then. And everyone flooding through down the straight. And now we're kind of left defending Devon Butler in the Renault. That's really helped him out, because of course he had a 10 place grip penalty and started all the way down in P19. But only just behind us, to be honest. And now down the inside he goes on us. And this was how bad the hard tyres were. I was powerless. It was like I was a turtle and Devon Butler was driving an actual F1 car through turn three. That was absolutely horrendous. There's nothing I could do about that. But I'm pretty sure these hard tyres were so bad, so bad. I'm pretty sure an ice cube would have more grip than these hard tyres, as they're kind of an inter-team battle going on here between Carlos Sainz and Lucas Weber. Lucas Weber on the inside, and that time is actually Pierre Gasly. Pierre Gasly now on the outside through the chicane, and I think Lucas Weber's got that position, and he has on lap 12, about to be lap 13. And now we're coming under pressure from Antonio Giovinazzi in the Mercedes. Side by side, round the outside tries Giovinazzi, we squeeze him out, and that's not today, Gio. You're not getting me that easy. But he's thinking about it, he's thinking about it, and now he's going to go to the inside into turn four. He definitely thought about that, but he didn't do it in the end. Here he comes though to the inside of us, heading down the second DRS straight into that corner. We go wide, and now we might even lose out to Pierre Gasly in the Renault. But we're not. Actually, we might though. Down the inside, he thought about it there. We've got a good enough exit. These tyres still absolutely horrendous on lap 13. We've been on them, what, 5 laps? Pit on lap 8. And now let's just see what we can do with these tyres onto lap 14. Pierre Gasly all over the back of us, and a bit of deja vu this from last season when we had that epic battle with Pierre Gasly before we went on to win the race. And now here comes Lucas Weber, and oh my god, Pierre Gasly nearly wiping out the sister team driver there. And we're going to go back down the inside, we're going to make it 3 wide. We've nearly got double move, and there's contact between us and Lucas Weber. And now down the inside of Lucas Weber there, he's somehow defending. Now our teammate, we've pushed him wide. Sorry, that is actually the Haas of Roman Grosjean getting the job done there. Wow, absolutely stunning. Skipping on though, a couple of laps, everyone around is kind of pitted, and into the pits goes the remaining stragglers there from the safety car pit stop. Roman Grosjean and Pierre Gasly and Sergio Perez, and also a Renault, and I think that's Devon Butler. So everyone kind of now in that awkward moment where they need to pit. Those softs have kind of done the distance, and out of the race goes Lando Norris. So that was not good for him. Skipping on to lap 23, we're still dragging these tyres out. Past us though goes Lewis Hamilton. We couldn't really do much with that. These tyres, they were kind of dead before we even put them on, to be honest, but they're definitely dead now. That Red Bull now catching us is in fact Carlos Sainz. Carlos Sainz, the championship leader in fact, so he's got definitely some overtaking to do in this race. He tried to get past us there into turn one, couldn't do it, and now round the outside at the second DRS zone he gets the job done. We make a bit of a mistake. Charles Leclerc now, we try and go all the way around the outside, we make a mistake, we wipe his front wing off there, off Charles Leclerc. Somehow Charles Leclerc still has a front wing after that. And now round the outside, we have to defend Carlos Sainz on lap 25, so there's literally 11 to go. At the end of lap 25, Carlos Sainz knows he can't get us around the outside, so he has to go down our inside, and that time we didn't have the exit to get the job done and re-overtake him. But it doesn't really matter, because very, very soon we will be pitting, because I wanted to try and get this hard to the end, but we were sitting in around P5 now. And as we come up to the end of lap 25, we are going to pit. There's a glitch in the pit lane. There's someone's tyre just chilling there. Marshall is not really doing their job in picking the corner, but we'll gloss over that. And now we are going to come into the pits, and for the last, seven laps, we are just going to push as hard as we can, put on the sauce. We're going to come out in P16, and now is literally the race to the points. So Romain Grosjean's beat us out. The two racing points have beat us out. Now it's just the race against the laps. One lap later, on to lap 27, we absolutely blitz Romain Grosjean in the Haas. And now we turn our attention to the racing point guys. And now we've got on the back of them. One lap later, we're on the back of Lance Stroll, then it's Sergio Perez. And now we're going to try and go to the inside, but we weren't quite close enough on that lap. Down the inside, that we think about it. It was close enough. As he defends though, does Lance Stroll. These guys been on these tyres since around lap 18, on lap 30, one lap later. We try and go around the outside of Lance Stroll and we've done it. That's a lovely move. And now we are four laps to get Sergio Perez and then get after the McLarens. Back down the inside though, tries Lance Stroll to be able to take us. We defend him because we really, really need to get through these guys as quickly as we can. Like I said a minute ago, it is a race against the laps in this race. And now on to lap 31, and we are past Sergio Perez clean, and with three laps to go, including this one, we can get after that McLaren. But unfortunately, on to the last lap then, rounds the final corner and wins this race, does Sebastian Vettel. It's an Alpha 1-2 with Bottas second. Carlos Sainz is going to come home to P3, running out the podium. Lewis Hamilton's going to be P4. P5 is going to go to Charles Leclerc. P6 is going to go to one of the Renaults. P7 is going to go to the other Renault. P9 is going to go to George Russell. And P10 is going to go to Nico Hülkenberg, as we just miss out and finish in P11.
I can't say that I'm happy with how today went, but I'm sure you gave it your best. Better luck next time.
A victory for Alfa Romeo. The team will certainly be celebrating tonight. Anthony Davidson, how do you think they were able to set themselves apart today?
Well, I know it's a bit of a boring answer, but the truth is they simply had the best speed package on the day, and a driver who knows how to take advantage of that. It doesn't matter how much time you spend poring over the stats and planning strategies if you can't keep the pace, and our winner today showed they could do both.
Alfa Romeo Racing in the number one spot on the podium today. A thrilling race and an excellent result for this team, who've never stopped fighting for that top step.
So that's been your 2021 Spanish Grand Prix for this season. Very, very, very good race. There was a lot and lot and lot of retirements. Just look at the list. So Max Verstappen, Alex Albon, Kevin Magnussen, and Lando Norris. And literally all of that came from that massive pileup at whatever corner it was before the chicane. And it's still leading the championship is Carlos Sainz. We have no points still, just the 10 points and nothing in the constructors to show for. Back into the paddock, and we have some decent R&D points. We're actually going to do an R&D upgrade that isn't going to be put on the car till Austria, unless it fails, then it'll be Silverstone. We're going to do an ultimate aero upgrade, and we're going to pick a rival, and I've decided to go with Nico Hülkenberg because I feel like he's the driver we end up battling the most, especially in this opening 5 rounds of the season. But this has been an absolutely long video. I'm sorry about that. This has been an absolutely amazing video to record. What a race that was. We have drama with the safety car. That race had everything. Unfortunately, we couldn't get the win. We couldn't even get a point. So hopefully next season, if there is a next season, then we could possibly do a little bit better. Just one position, that'll be enough for me, enough for points. But I hope you enjoyed this video. This is kind of dragging on a bit because there's so much that happened in this episode. If you've enjoyed this video and you want to see more, make sure to hit the like button and subscribe, and hit the bell as well so you're notified when these career videos go out to the world. But until next time, guys, I hope you enjoyed this race as much as I did recording it. Goodbye.